WOKQ. Yeah, they got the good stuff. Second date update. They're a lot of fun. I'm not dumb. They got famous people 411. Now just make sure then that you tell everyone. Kira and Logan never broke my heart. I'm listening every morning. Can't wait for them to start. Yeah, she's bubbly and he's just goofy. They're both sharp as a dart. Kira and Logan have never broke my heart.
Greetings,
Earthlings.
Hey there. It is Monday, November 13th. Welcome to another work week. And Logan, how are you? Did you have a good weekend?
I had a really good weekend. A little tired today. So like I told you on Friday, we had a big old day drinking plan on Saturday. So it was really fun. I love being like a tourist in my own town. And that's what we do. I don't know. I would say like once a month or maybe once every other month. We just bop around Portsmouth as if we've never been to the shops or never been to the bars before. But it was a lot of fun. And you know how I do. I brought my water bottle into every single location.
Oh, yes.
Not one person stopped me. If you don't know what we're talking about, the question at hand that was on Friday, is it rude to bring water bottles into bars and restaurants? The tribe chimed in on this question, and we're going to replay it for you right now.
God makes the good stuff, and we're not talking about whiskey here. We're talking about water. Yeah. Do you bring your water bottle into a restaurant? Okay, our tribe wanted to chime in on this one.
Can you bring your own water bottle into restaurants, bars, breweries, etc.? Why or why not?
I had this dilemma the other day, actually, because I was trying to go into a bar, and I still had my water bottle fully full. But in a bar, I think it's okay if you bring it in if it's empty. Because that way, if anybody stops, you're like, there's nothing in here. Sorry, I just have this on me and I can't bring it out. Like, I don't have a way to, like, keep it anywhere.
Sure.
Restaurants, though, I feel like it's just water and, like, you can put it down by your feet. I've done that a few times before.
Okay. So you do it. You bring your water bottle frequently.
Yes, but bars and restaurants for me are different.
Okay. Taylor, what do you think about this?
Yeah, I mean, it's not something I've ever done, but like I can see that explanation why that would be totally okay.
So the reason this is coming up is because our second date update this week, a guy, Liam, tried to bring in his water bottle into a restaurant. Now, this is something that I do everywhere. I always have my water bottle on me. If I'm walking downtown Portsmouth, I have it.
Okay.
Last minute, we're like, hey, let's go pop in and grab a drink. I'll bring my water bottle in. Now, Justine, the lady who Liam was out on a date with, was anti-water bottle, saying, why the heck are you bringing your water bottle? More importantly, where they were going to dinner wouldn't let them in because he had a water bottle.
That would be my take, is the restaurant wouldn't allow you in because are they going to check to see what's in there? I mean, if let's put it this way. Wine is about $17 to $19 a glass. If someone's going to let me in with a water bottle, there's going to be wine inside my water bottle. I mean, but think about it.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't do that, certainly, but think about it, really. So who's going to check? I don't think a restaurant would even allow a water bottle to come in.
Depends on the restaurant, right?
I guess.
I guess I'll
have to find that restaurant and fill my water bottle with wine.
I've never been stopped. But I also don't go to high-end places. Let's make that very clear. You know what I mean? I'm walking into the 99s with a water bottle. They ain't stopping me.
I mean, at that point, why wouldn't he just bring a flask?
A flask of water?
I don't know. I mean, if, like, you already know the restaurant doesn't allow you in, why can't he just bring, like, slip a flask? I don't know. That's just one thought I just thought of. But I carry my water bottle everywhere with
me. So like, you do. You bring your water bottle into locations. Back on
and
track.
And one of the locations that I feel like so many people talk about is, like, you can't bring things into a movie theater. Like, you have to buy it there or, like, they'll get mad at you if you bring it in. I bring a huge purse with me, and every single time, I go to Five Below before, grab candy, and then I have my huge water bottle with me. Or, like, there have been times where I'll go to McDank's, and I'll get Diet Coke, put it in my water bottle, and then I go. And never have I ever been stopped by a 16-year-old kid saying, tickets, and then they, like, let me go by.
So bottom line, you're bringing a water bottle any public place, regardless of what they're serving.
Yeah, maybe I'll get a flask now.
Love it.
And the tribe has spoken on 97.5 WOKQ. 97.5 WOKQ. Good morning. It's the time of the morning where we just, you know, want to make sure you're safe. And if there's frost on your pumpkin this morning, or if you're running out to your car, you might want to warm it up because there's definitely something going on called freezing cold.
Yeah, I know. Are you a car starter in the morning?
I
try not to for whatever reason unless I need it. And this morning, I went to the car to get in, or I went into my car to come to work, and I started it and went back into the house. I was ready to go. I was like, you know what? I'm going to give it 3 minutes, and I started it and went back into the house.
Yeah.
Hung out for three.
Here we go.
All right, mind bender o'clock, the question at hand. After 1 year of marriage, couples were asked to name their biggest complaint. This is the number one answer. Give us a call on the East Coast Lumber Building Supply listener line, 603-749-0975. WOKQ, who's this?
Hi, it's Mike Merrimack. How are you?
Hey, Mike. I'm well. Jeannie, how are you?
Good morning, Mike. I'm awesome for a Monday.
Good morning. Yeah, sorry for a Monday. I can't complain yet, you know?
Sure. Yeah, you always have to, like, constitute that it's a Monday. Okay, Mike, after 1 year of marriage, couples were asked to name their biggest complaint. This was the number one answer. What is it?
I'm going to say snoring. Their partner snoring.
Snoring.
Oh.
Yeah, that is brutal. I would just get up and go to the other room. If I'm not sleeping well, see ya. Go to the couch or something.
You're not a snorer, obviously.
Well, she's not. I don't know about me. I'm sleeping.
Are you a snorer? Do you snore?
I am a snorer. I do, yes.
Well, that sounds like a personal complaint over here. Not the answer, Mike. Good guess. Not the answer we're looking for, though.
Thanks for calling, Mike.
Thank you. Have a good day, guys.
You too. WOKQ, who's this?
This is Alan.
Alan? Have you ever called in, Alan? I don't think I've heard your name before.
No, I have not.
Well, welcome. First time. How you doing, man? Oh, did I lose you?
Nope, I'm here.
Oh, okay. Let's get right to the question then. All business, Alan. After 1 year of marriage, couples were asked to name their biggest complaint. This is the number one answer. What is it?
Snoring.
Alan, the caller before you guessed the same thing, not the answer.
Thank you.
But a good answer, and thank you. Have an awesome day. Well, there you go. Snoring seems to be a big problem.
I know.
In marriages.
I feel like we could do a whole segment on this. Complain about your spouse anonymously, please. No, it's not snoring. After 1 year of marriage, couples were asked to name their biggest complaint. This is the number one answer. I think a hint is best given by example for this one. So for me, to avoid this, I play soccer every Wednesday. I golf. My wife and I go to separate gyms.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's a great idea, actually.
Yep. What do you do to avoid this?
So, my husband loves to drive, just get out and drive.
Okay.
Personally, I go to retail therapy. I go shopping. I don't necessarily buy anything either. It's just the act of looking.
Yeah, that blows my mind. But I get it. I get it. You're doing that for you. After 1 year of marriage, couples were asked to name their biggest complaint. This is the number one answer, 603-749-0975. Getting to your calls in about 5 minutes on 97.5 WOKQ. Not bad. It's a Monday, Jeannie. You don't got to clench your teeth. It wasn't bad.
A little slow on the uptake, but not bad. Not bad. The good stuff is brought to you by Wicks and Construction. Find them at wicksandconstruction.com. All right, it's something we don't think about, but it is a problem. When a homeless person passes away, especially a military vet who has served our country and deserves so much of our respect, right?
For sure.
Who's at their funeral?
I don't know.
Who are the 6 pallbearers?
I don't know. You're saying all these things, and I don't know the answers.
No, it's a sad situation. But high school students at the University of Detroit Jesuit School are serving as pallbearers for military veterans who don't have a family, or maybe they were homeless when they died.
Cool.
Doesn't that make your heart
feel
good? This
is great.
These teens volunteer their time for funeral ceremonies for those who would otherwise be buried alone, and the school's it's a pallbearer ministry that they started in 2015 when 6 seniors volunteered to help bury 3 unclaimed vets.
Wow.
And that program is still growing strong today.
That's great.
Isn't that awesome?
Yeah, good for them.
That makes me feel good, especially about the youth. So here's another story, sort of about a veteran. He saved the day, I will tell you that. But imagine you're driving your 2 kids to their daily activities and something goes terribly wrong. You start choking.
Whoa.
And you can't get help.
The driver?
The driver.
Oh, no.
The mom starts choking. 2 kids, 2 young kids in the back seat watching this happen, right?
Oh, no.
That's what happened to a woman on a highway in Chicago. And that's when truck driver Jeff Hannes became a hero.
He went into action when he saw the woman was pulled over on the side of the road, and he stopped and ran over and said, "Are you choking?" And she gave that international choking sign.
Yeah,
with her hands
everybody
around
should
her
know
throat.
What that
yep.
is.
Mm-hmm. The hands over the throat. And his training as a retired Army sergeant kicked into play.
Awesome.
He said, "I just launched into the Heimlich remover," and she responded. And then he thought about the tragic outcome if he hadn't stopped to help her.
Yeah, she had no one. She was alone.
Yeah, yeah.
The kids weren't doing it.
No, but he saved the day.
That's great.
And Logan, what do you call that?
That's the good stuff on 97.5 WOKQ.
Here's the Famous People 411 with Kira and Logan in the morning on 97.5 WOKQ.
Famous People Doing Stuff is brought to you by Merchants Auto in Hooksett, New Hampshire. So the 66th Grammy nominations have just been announced. And you know who got snubbed yet again?
Morgan Wallen.
Morgan Wallen got snubbed yet again. He had no nominations for Song of the Year, Record of the Year, or Album of the
what
Year.
What is happening here?
To make things worse, Best Country Album, he's not even on it.
How?
He's not even on it. His album was, he had like all of the top, all of his songs on his album for this year were on the top 200 at once for weeks. He had two songs that were in the top three for weeks and weeks. I don't know why, but the world is against Morgan Wallen and I feel bad.
Yeah, me too.
Jelly Roll, however, got his nomination for Best New Artist, and this clip is just so pure. Hit it, Jenny.
I'm not sure if I'll post this or not because I'm so emotional, but the greatest honor an artist can ever hear is that they've been nominated for a Grammy. And I got to hear that this morning.
Oh.
So emotional, so raw, just to know where he came from. He is just such a good guy. Here's a clip of an example of how Jelly Roll is such a good guy. So after the CMAs, he was getting tons and tons of attention, of course. I mean, everybody wanted to talk to him. Nate Smith was in an interview with someone at the CMAs. Now, the interviewer and whoever was recording him saw Jelly Roll and immediately stopped the interview with Nate Smith and went to, you know, kind of grab Jelly Roll.
Rude.
It is rude. Jelly Roll put all of the attention right back on Nate Smith. Listen to this.
Icon!
Hey, yo, Nate Smith.
Oh, no! There
I just want you to know. You set my world on fire.
Oh, brother. I love you, man.
I'm so proud of that. Single's moving incredible.
Thank you, brother.
So good to see it flying the way it is.
How good is that, Jenny?
Wow.
He put the attention right back on him. He sang his song. He said, you know, that single's amazing. It's going to do well. Jelly Roll is just such a good guy. If you're wondering what you should get somebody for Christmas, Jelly Roll has a perfect suggestion. Here it is.
If you're like me, finding that perfect gift for everyone on your list can be overwhelming. And that's why I'm so pleased to share a special gift that you can give to one and all. The gift of tattoos!
Shocker that he's suggesting tattoos. If you are getting into Christmas spirit, Walker Hayes has done a little twist on his song, Fancy Like Christmas Edition.
Fancy like Christmas.
I've been told, I haven't listened to the full thing, but I've been told the Applebee's line is still in there, but that song is now available. Walker Hayes, well done, creating a little Christmas jingle that we all want to hear. Jenny, did you know that Elf was released over 20 years ago?
Get out.
I had no clue that movie was 20 plus years old.
And we still watch it every single Christmas.
That movie has to go down as the greatest Christmas movie of all time, right?
I would think so.
Yeah,
one of
too.
Our favorites.
Last but not least, we're not going to talk about it much more than this. The New England Patriots lost 6-10. They scored a field goal, like, in their first drive. So they were up 3-0, and they ended up 6 points. So they got another field goal in the fourth quarter. It was painful. Mac Jones got benched at the last drive. They put Bailey Zappi in for the very last drive with under 2 minutes. Anyway, that's all I got for the famous people doing stuff.
Did you see O'Brien just rimming him out?
Oh, just ripped him out. As he should have. As he should have. He deserved it. That's the famous people doing stuff on 97.5
W. It's Kira and Logan in the morning with Jenny on the side. Kira is off on maternity leave. If you haven't heard by now, she had a baby girl. All is good in the world. And it is good in the world because Christmas is almost here and we're very excited. So the question of the day is, when is it too early to decorate for Christmas?
What's your opinion, Ginny?
Well, my opinion is we're decorating this weekend, but it's only a week before Thanksgiving, so I feel like it's not that early. But Christmas is our favorite holiday, and we want to keep the lights and decorations up as long as possible.
Mm-hmm.
But some people already have everything up. My neighbors, I have three neighbors already with the Christmas tree up.
No, they don't.
They do.
They already have a Christmas tree.
Yes, in their window because we have big
I didn't even
windows.
Know farms are already open for that.
Not everybody has a real tree.
Okay. Oh, I got an opinion on that.
No. Yeah, save that because I got an opinion on that
we'll
too.
We'll talk about that another day. Yeah, my sister and her wife did it the weekend after Halloween, if not the day after Halloween.
Get out.
So that's a little early for me. I love Christmas, but one of the best things about Christmas is that it is a short period of time, and you feel all kinds of holiday joy because it's that short period of time.
Yeah.
You start leaking into October, that's a little crazy. Listen, like I said, I love Christmas. I get giddy like a kid. However, before, I would say like the 20th of November, that's crazy.
Oh, no. What? No, you're wrong. Think about Thanksgiving decorations.
Yeah?
They're nothing. Sorry, they're not a big deal.
Listen, I'm down for it to be decorated around Thanksgiving, but to do it before November 15th or November 20th, maybe 10 days before December, is perhaps what I think is the earliest you should do.
I disagree.
But you're letting fall go. You're just saying, see you later, fall. I'm already expecting the deep, dark winter.
We've had 2 months of fall, September, October.
Oh, September's like summer here still, Jen.
True enough.
That's our question of the day. When is the appropriate time to decorate for Christmas or the holidays?
Shall we bribe them?
We're going to bribe them for sure. What do we got for grabs?
$50 Kittery Trading Post gift card for the caller, somebody who randomly calls in and chimes in on this topic and gives us a good, funny dose of reality.
Yeah, dose of reality. That's true. When is the right time to set up for Christmas and the holidays? 603-7...
And we are taking your calls. When is it too early to decorate for Christmas? I don't know.
Some say never. Some say anything before Thanksgiving. I don't. There's a big variety here, you know. I mean, Junie's on board with the early decorations. I'm on board with an early decoration, but I don't think you can go before, like, November 20th, because that's still fall to me. Like, we're still in fall time right now, so I feel like it's not quite the Christmas season. Plus, the shorter you make it, the more special it is. But that's the question at hand. When's the right time to set up and start decorating for Christmas? 603-749-0975. WOKQ, who's this?
Hello.
Hey, who's this?
This is Jeff from Candia.
All right, Jeff. When's the right time to start celebrating for the holidays and Christmas?
So it kind of depends on how crazy you're going.
Okay.
So if you're doing crazy decorations on the outside, you got to start around Halloween, so that you're done.
Yes.
By mid-November, like a day like today when it's freezing cold out.
Whoa.
But normally, I would say right around Thanksgiving.
Okay. So what do you do at your house?
Well, I used to do 40 to 60,000 lights, and I would have to start at the end of September to get them all done.
Holy smokes.
I'm usually partially lit by right after Halloween.
Partially lit?
Yeah, because I still had more lights to put up. But, you know, then now that I don't do as much outside because just don't have the time to do it, we set ours up on Thanksgiving Eve.
Okay. Okay, see, this feels right, the secondary. Putting them up September 30th seems a little bit crazy to me.
He's saying right after Halloween, and I agree with that because it does take a while to decorate, and you can't half decorate. Like, outside you can add lights, but inside, once you start decorating, you have to keep going.
Unless you got the frustration of one light goes out, you're chasing that. So you got to have the time to, figure out the lights. And I just started buying new lights every year because I spent way too much time trying to fix the bulbs. So it gets expensive.
This guy does not show up late to any events. He is so prepared.
Gotta be.
Hey, thanks so much for the call. Let's put you on hold and put you in the running for this Kittery Trading Post gift card.
Sounds good. Thank you.
Thank you for waking up with Kira and Logan in the morning with a side of Ginny on 97.5 WOKQ.
I wish I would have met you anywhere but where I did. Some old high-rise town that I won't ever go again. Wish we would have rolled around some old cabin, chased them city lights, hit bars out. Silver dollar hanging out by Silverado down the road. I love
down them roads we used to ride.
In Vegas, want to go? 3-digit code coming up at 8:20 this morning, including air, hotel, $500 spending money, and more. That's in just in about an hour from now. 97.5 WOKQ.
When is the right time to start decorating for Christmas?
I start decorating November 1st.
Whoa. When are you done by?
I did it all on November 1st, but I have a logical reason of why I did it.
All right, hit me with the logic.
Okay. So 2 weeks before, like, Halloween ended, I went to the stores to try to find some Thanksgiving decorations, and they had nothing. It was either Halloween or Christmas. So I just admitted defeat and decorated for Christmas.
That's what Jeannie said, too. Jeannie said that she tries to keep up with the stores, and since the stores go early, she goes early.
Yeah.
Right. That's what I did.
And there aren't any great Thanksgiving, really, decorations. I mean, turkeys, and that's about it. Right?
Yeah, pretty much. They didn't have nothing.
Mm. I'm just wondering about people who host Thanksgiving and Christmas. You have Christmas decorations up from your Thanksgiving lunch all the way through to your Christmas dinner? Is it the same?
Absolutely.
Yeah, why not?
A celebration is a celebration. One would say, listen, I love Christmas, but one would say it takes away the festive fun time that is Christmas. The earlier you do it, it's like it loses its value.
Yeah, but the stores didn't have anything, so.
You're right. That's a good point. It's all Christmas after Halloween. It's all Christmas all the time, all day long.
Right.
The big box stores, the conglomerates, they own us. They control us.
They do.
Hey, Nicole, thanks so much for your call. We have your number, so we're going to put you. WOKQ, who's this?
Alicia.
All right, Alicia, when is it appropriate to decorate for Christmas?
So we have a little friendly competition.
Ooh.
We start decorating, and then it becomes a who decorates better.
Whoa.
Is this in your neighborhood?
Yes. We don't really know the neighbors. They just moved in. They're not really too friendly, but so we just waited until they started decorating, and then we just overdo there.
Oh, man. I could not live in a neighborhood like this because my competitive nature would dedicate thousands of dollars to being the best.
Yes.
I would just lose money.
Yes.
My mom is just as much into it as I am.
Alicia, is it safe to assume that your house is going to be the best Christmas lights on the block?
Yep. We did the same thing for Halloween, so.
Oh, you're the house. I see.
And do you just have Christmas lights, or do you have extra displays that is, worth visiting?
The whole works. Inside, outside.
Alicia, do you want to give your address for everyone to go by your house?
No, thank you.
I didn't think so. Hey, we have your number. We'll put you in the running for this KTP gift card.
Thanks, Alicia.
Thanks for the call, Alicia. Merry Christmas. Bye. We do have more stuff to give. It's not just Kittery Trading Post gift card. Jenny, what are we giving away when we play Can't Be Kira?
Logan, I am so excited for this prize this week. Joe D. Messina is coming to the Hampton Beach Casino Ballroom. It is a 90s country show, but it's not. It's so much more than that. That's Friday, June 7th, and some lucky person will be winning those tickets today.
That's if and only if you can beat or tie Ginny. It's a Monday. She's hurting. You're hurting. Let's play 603.
I'm not hurting.
I'm just trying to hype him up, Ginny. Come on now. 603-749-0975. That's the East Coast Lumber Building Supply listener line. Do you want to play Can't Beat Ginny? 603-749-0975. We play Can't Beat Ginny in about 10 minutes on 97.5 WOKQ.
Bring it.
It's going down. Think you've got what it takes?
Oh, yeah.
Well, let's see.
Ready, set, here we go.
It's time to play Can't Beat Kira on 97.5 WOKQ.
Good morning, Ryan. You're on with Kira and Logan in the morning with a side of Ginny.
How's it going?
It's going. How are you doing?
Not too bad.
Hey, Ryan.
Hey, how are you?
Awesome.
Are you setting up for Christmas or what?
Yeah, a little bit, actually.
Wow. All right. All right. Maybe I'm late. Maybe I got to jump on the damn bandwagon.
Late to the party again, Logan.
All right. All right. All right. Let's do this. Ryan, you are here for Can't Beat Ginny. Have you ever played before?
No.
Okay. Well, do you know how we start?
I do. Yep.
Do it up, man.
Kick me out.
Get out of here, Ginny.
All right, Ryan.
She is gonzo. Let's see how these work. I got two questions that are SpongeBob related. Do you know SpongeBob at all, Ryan?
A little bit.
A little bit. Hopefully you know the beginning part. Question number one, what is the start of the SpongeBob SquarePants theme song?
Who lives in a pineapple under the sea?
Okay. All right. Question number two, who is the Chum Bucket's owner? He's also the show's main villain on SpongeBob.
Plankton.
Question number three. This is Walker Hayes, fancy like. Yeah, we're fancy like Applebee's on a date night. Got that Bourbon Street steak with the Oreo shake. Got some blank.
Yeah, I'm not passing that.
Pass right away. Okay, I'll call Ginny back. That was fast. You're decisive. You know what you know, and you don't know what you don't know.
Oh, Ryan. All right.
Ginny, you ready to start?
I'm ready.
Question number one.
Yep.
What is the start of the SpongeBob SquarePants theme song?
Oh, I can hear it in my head. He lives in the bottom on something in the bottom of the deep blue sea.
You're thinking of who lives?
Who lives who in lives. The bottom? Yeah, who lives?
I was really looking for "Are You Ready, Kids?"
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
So Ryan also sang what you sang. So I think it's fair to just say nobody gets the point.
All right, I'm good with that, Ryan. You good?
Good bid.
Yeah.
Question number two, 0-0. Question number two. Who is the Chum Bucket's owner? He's the show's main villain.
Oh, I haven't seen the show in so many years.
The villain on SpongeBob. Any guesses there, Ginny?
I'll notice as soon as you say it. I don't know. I know.
It's Plankton.
Plankton. Yes.
And Ryan got that right, so it's one zip Rye guy. Question number three. This is Walker Hayes, fancy like. Yeah, we're fancy like Applebee's on a date night. Got that Bourbon Street steak with the Oreo shake. Get some blank.
Oh, my God. It is definitely a Monday. I am...
Blanked?
I'm blanked, but I know it. That's the thing. And I know Ryan got it.
Get some whipped cream on top, too. Ah, Ginny got it wrong. Ryan got it wrong.
Ryan, it's a Monday. We're just not...
I'm not too good at lyrics anyway, so...
Well... Ginny, I don't know how these words are going to taste coming out of your mouth, but you owe Ryan the phrase of shame.
Ryan from Epsom. I'm Ginny from Dover, and I can't beat you on Can't Beat Ginny.
Well, it is Monday.
Oh, well, thanks for that, because you know what? You get the tickets anyway, and Jody Messina is so fun. We haven't seen her in this area in so long. You're going to see her June 7th at Hampton Beach Casino Ballroom, baby.
Thank you.
Nice job, Ryan. Thanks for waking up with Kira and Logan in the morning with a side of Ginny on 97.5 W. Carrie from Wakefield, you're on with Kira and Logan in the morning. Hey, girl.
Hi, dear.
Did you say, hey, dear? That's the nicest way to start this conversation. Thank you.
I believe she said, hi there.
Hi, there.
Oh. Womp, womp, womp.
Poor Logie. We should have just let him think it.
Come on, Carrie. All right.
Yeah, I know.
You got a wild animal encounter?
So, yes, I do. When I was a teenager, which was a very long time ago, my boyfriend at the time, now husband, decided to take a nature walk and took me out in the woods. We were walking, and all of a sudden there was this crazy slapping sound. Like, super scary at the time, you know, 16 years old, not expecting it.
Sure.
And I was like, what was that? And then he said, oh, I don't know. So we keep walking, and another one happens, and it's louder. And I go, oh, my gosh, I don't know what that is. I turn and he is gone.
Your boyfriend?
Me in the woods, and it turns out it was a beaver slapping the water, but it was like the scariest noise ever. But he just left me. So now, 20 something years later, I tell my kids all the time, don't leave. Don't leave your friends in the woods. If something happens, make sure you take your friends with you. So.
Don't do what daddy did.
I'm sure he has so much regret. Like, that's been weighing on him since he was 16 years old.
And now it's on the radio?
And you're never going to let him live it down.
No, that's my favorite story to tell. I tell everybody that he was the bigger wimp. He left me in the woods.
Over a beaver.
Absolutely
over
hilarious.
Over a beaver.
Morgan from Ossipee, are you there?
I'm here.
Hey, would you like to share your wild animal encounter?
Absolutely.
Spill it.
So, it was last summer. I went hiking on my favorite mountain with my dog. I was probably about, 3 months pregnant or so. And we're coming down the mountain, and I thought somebody else was coming up the trail. So we stopped because I hike with my dog off leash, so I, you know, grabbed him so they could come up and whatever. And all of a sudden, I look up, and there's a bear in the tree. And I was like, oh, my goodness, look at that. So I was like, okay, we'll just make our way by. And then I had a moment of realization where I was like, oh, my gosh, that's a baby bear. And then no sooner that I thought that, Mama bear was charging through the woods. So I screamed and did as Kira said, and I was like, we got to go.
Probably peed your pants a little
bit.
Did
you run?
Yep. Especially being pregnant, I was like, oh my gosh, I have to get out of here. And I let my dog go, and he chased the bear back into the woods, and I was shaking the rest of the way down the mountain.
Wait, the dog scared off the bear and saved the day?
He did.
What a loyal, loyal bubby.
And he protected your cub, your unborn cub.
97.5 WOKQ. Good morning, Kira and Logan in the morning with a side of Ginny. So, Logan, it is Friday.
Ugh, thank God we made it.
Right?
We made it, Mama, we made it.
We made it, Mama. And, you know, Friday means time to get your weekend on,
yes.
Which may mean a little imbibing for some people.
Definitely. Beverages will be had after this week.
Okay, that's a sure thing for Logan, and probable for me. But I haven't played a drinking game in a long time. What about you?
You know, I feel like as I get older, my drinking games have gone down.
Yeah, but that happens.
But they're fun. Mm-hmm. Like it's always fun. You know, you're hanging out with a group of people and you're having cocktails and talking. I think drinking games kind of gets everyone involved, whether you're playing it or you're next up to play. Because not all drinking games you can play with a group of people.
True enough.
But I think it really helps the energy of the night.
All right. Well, let's see what the tribe has to say about this.
What is the best drinking game of all time? Go ahead, Cheryl.
I've never played a drinking game.
You've never played any drinking games?
Never, ever.
You played cornhole?
I second that. I've also never played a drinking game.
Wait.
I think she's my daughter.
Are you kidding me?
This is a little concerning.
How could this be?
Wait, time out. Wait, Cheryl and Meg, come back up, please. Riley, step away.
Get a cord.
You guys have played cornhole before, and perhaps that doesn't constitute as a drinking game, but you play it while drinking 99% of the time. That's why it's one hand, you got a beer in the other.
I've never done those two things at the same time, I'm sorry to say. But
neither have I.
But I will now that I know that's an official drinking game. I thought a drinking game was, what's that beer one? Beer bong?
Beer pong.
Beer pong.
Beer pong. Yes. Beer bong.
Musical beers.
A different word.
Yeah, it's a day. That's something different. Cheryl, we can talk offline about that. I'd love to, in fact. Okay. Okay. All right. Next.
Okay.
That's crazy. Taylor, do you have a favorite drinking game?
For me, I'm a big beer die guy.
Okay.
Big fan of that game.
And can you very briefly explain beer die?
Yeah, so you got a table and you have solo cups at each of the corners of the table, and you take a die and you try and throw it up in the air and basically get the die in the cup or hit the cup and have it hit the ground after.
Yep, great explanation. Also a phenomenal drinking game. Yeah. Lydia, what is your favorite drinking game?
I love Slap Cup.
Okay.
Slap Cup is so fun. It gets super intense. Quick little synopsis. It's you have a bunch of cups in the center that are filled probably like a quarter of the way with alcohol. If you're being generous, maybe more. You have to bounce the ball into a cup that's going around the circle, and there's two cups circulating at once at all times. And then if you get next to someone and they don't get it in, and you do, you can slap their cup away, and then that person has to drink.
Yeah.
And it gets super intense. Cups are flying everywhere. It's a great time.
That's a good game because many people can play it. The only downfall with that game is it's really messy. Like, you're getting alcohol spilt everywhere, so you better be playing outside.
Took the words right out of my mouth.
Right?
Oh.
A cleaner version is also Stack Cup, too.
Less slapping, more stacking. All right, Beach?
I was going to say I like Stack Cup. Stack Cup is really fun. There's also another game called Kings, where it's really fun. There's just one can of your desired drink of choice. I don't know. And then you have to, every single person, I would say around like 10 people play. You pick up a card. Each card like means something in the deck. And then you have to like stick it under the tab of the can.
Right.
And then the first person to like crack the can has to drink the whole thing.
Yep.
It's cool. It's like, it's something silly.
Cheryl, did you understand that? Basically, there's a task associated with every kind of card in the deck of 52 cards.
Oh, okay.
And once you do it, you take the card that was pulled, put it under the
the tab. Whoever, like Riley says, whoever bursts the tab, it goes.
Yeah.
Love that sound. You have to drink it.
And you have to drink the whole beer?
And you have to drink the whole, well, whatever you're playing, whatever canned beer, beverage you're playing with.
Whatever the beverage is.
For Riley, it's a transfusion.
Those, oh, you can't joke with me right now. Those are so good. I love those.
Another great game for a large group of people.
Okay, I have one more thing.
Okay.
Meg and I are having a sidebar, and she's saying to me, I would just rather drink. And you know, I
why
have,
would you play a game why, while drinking?
My sentiment exactly. If I'm going to have my wine, I don't want to play for it.
She doesn't mess around.
I just want to have it.
I'm in the same boat. Why would I play a game for some gross can of beer when I can sip a cocktail of choice at my own leisure?
Fair enough.
So practical.
There you have it. The tribe has spoken.
Here's the Famous People 411 with Kira and Logan in the morning on 97.5 WOKQ.
Famous People Doing Stuff is brought to you by Merchants Auto in Hooksett, New Hampshire. So the 66th Grammy nominations have just been announced. And you know who got snubbed yet again?
Morgan Wallen.
Morgan Wallen got snubbed yet again. He had no nominations for Song of the Year, Record of the Year, or Album of the
Year. What is happening here?
To make things worse, Best Country Album, he's not even on it.
How?
He's not even on it. His album was, he had like all of the top, all of his songs on his album from this year were on the top 200 at once for weeks. He had two songs that were in the top three for weeks and weeks. I don't know why, but the world is against Morgan Wallen and I feel bad.
Yeah, me too.
Jelly Roll, however, got his nomination for Best New Artist, and this clip is just so pure. Hit it, Jenny.
I'm not sure if I'll post this or not because I'm so emotional, but the greatest honor an artist can ever hear is that they've been nominated for a Grammy. I got to hear that this morning.
Oh,
so emotional, so raw, just to know where he came from. He is just such a good guy. Here's a clip of an example of how Jelly Roll is such a good guy. So after the CMAs, he was getting tons and tons of attention, of course. I mean, everybody wanted to talk to him. Nate Smith was in an interview with someone at the CMAs. Now, the interviewer and whoever was recording him saw Jelly Roll and immediately stopped the interview with Nate Smith and went to, you know, kind of grab Jelly Roll.
Rude.
Ah, it is rude. Jelly Roll put all of the attention right back on Nate Smith. Listen to this.
Icon!
You have Nate Smith.
Oh, no!
I just want you to know. You set my world on fire.
Oh, brother. I love you, man. I'm so proud of you. That single's moving incredible.
Thank you, brother.
So good to see it flying the way it is.
How good is that, Jenny?
Wow.
He put the attention right back on him. He sang his song. He said, you know, that single's amazing. It's going to do well. Jelly Roll is just such a good guy. If you're wondering what you should get somebody for Christmas, Jelly Roll has a perfect suggestion. Here it is.
If you're like me, finding that perfect gift for everyone on your list can be overwhelming. And that's why I'm so pleased to share a special gift that you can give to one and all. The gift of tattoos!
Shocker that he's suggesting tattoos. If you are getting into Christmas spirit, Walker Hayes has done a little twist on his song, Fancy Like Christmas Edition.
Fancy like Christmas.
I've been told, I haven't listened to the full thing, but I've been told the Applebee's line is still in there, but that song is now available. Walker Hayes, well done, creating a little Christmas jingle that we all want to hear. Jenny, did you know that Elf was released over 20 years ago?
Get out.
I had no clue that movie was 20 plus years old.
And we still watch it every single Christmas.
That movie has to go down as the greatest Christmas movie of all time, right?
I would think so.
Yeah,
one of
too.
Our favorites.
Last but not least, we're not going to talk about it much more than this. The New England Patriots lost 6-10. They scored a field goal, like, in their first drive. So they were up 3-0, and they ended up 6 points. So they got another field goal in the fourth quarter. It was painful. Mac Jones got benched at the last drive. They put Bailey Zappi in for the very last drive with under 2 minutes. Anyway, that's all I got for the famous people doing stuff.
Did you see O'Brien just rimming him out?
Oh, he just ripped him out. As he should have. As he should have. He deserved it. That's the famous people doing stuff on 97.5 WOKQ.
Good.
Hey, How you guys feeling? Feeling good? Not bad. It's a Monday, Ginny. You don't got to clench your teeth. It wasn't bad.
A little slow on the uptake, but not bad. Not bad. The good stuff is brought to you by Wicks and Construction. Find them at wicksandconstruction.com. All right. It's something we don't think about, but it is a problem. When a homeless person passes away, especially a military vet who has served our country and deserves so much of our respect, right?
For sure.
Who's at their funeral?
I don't know.
Who are the six pallbearers?
I don't know. You're saying all these things, and I don't know the answers.
No, it's a sad situation. But high school students at the University of Detroit Jesuit School are serving as pallbearers for military veterans who don't have a family, or maybe they were homeless when they died.
Cool.
Doesn't that make your heart feel good? These teens volunteer their time for funeral ceremonies for those who would otherwise be buried alone, and the school's it's a pallbearer ministry that they started in 2015 when six seniors volunteered to help bury three unclaimed vets.
Wow.
And that program is still growing strong today.
That's great.
Isn't that awesome?
Yeah, yeah, good for them.
That makes me feel good, especially about the youth. So here's another story, sort of about a veteran. He saved the day, I will tell you that. But imagine you're driving your two kids to their daily activities and something goes terribly wrong. You start choking.
Whoa.
And you can't get help.
The driver?
The driver.
Oh, no.
The mom starts choking. Two young kids in the back seat watching this happen,
right? Oh, no, no, no.
That's what happened to a woman on a highway in Chicago. And that's when truck driver Jeff Hannes became a hero. He went into action when he saw the woman was pulled over on the side of the road. And he stopped and ran over and said, "Are you choking?" And she gave that international choking sign
with
her hands
everybody
around her
throat. Everybody should know what that is.
Mm-hmm. And the hands over the throat. And his training as a retired Army sergeant kicked into play.
Awesome.
He said, "I just launched into the Heimlich remover," and she responded. And then he thought about the tragic outcome if he hadn't stopped to help her.
Yeah, she had no one. She was alone.
Yeah, yeah.
The kids weren't doing it.
No, but he saved the day.
That's great.
And Logan, what do you call that?
That's the good stuff on 97.5 WOKQ.
George Birch, 97.5 WOKQ. Kira and Logan in the morning with a side of Ginny. It is time for compliments, takebacks, and apologies brought to you by Merchants Auto in Hooksett, New Hampshire. We do this every morning. Kind of fast rewind or review of what we thought, heard this morning.
Yeah.
And I got to tell you, I got to give big kudos to the University of Detroit Jesuit School. These high school students started this pallbearer ministry for vets who have no family.
Yeah, it's pretty incredible what they're doing, Ginny.
I think it's incredible. And so every time there is a veteran who has no family, they volunteer to be the pallbearers and to be there at their funeral. And I think that's exceptional. Our veterans need that kind of respect. And kudos to these guys for doing it.
Yeah, I agree. I'm giving a compliment today to Jeff from Candia. He won our Kittery Trading Post gift card today. The topic today was, when is it too early, or better yet, when is it appropriate to set up for Christmas decorations? Here's Jeff's call. I'll explain why I'm complimenting him after.
So it kind of depends on how crazy you're going.
Okay.
So if you're doing crazy decorations on the outside, you got to have start around Halloween so that you're done.
Yes.
By mid-November, like a day like today when it's freezing cold out.
Whoa.
But normally, I would say right around Thanksgiving.
Okay. So what do you do at your house?
Well, I used to do 40 to 60,000 lights, and I would have to start at the end of September to get them all done.
Holy smokes.
I'm usually partially lit by right after Halloween.
Partially lit?
Yeah, because I still had more lights to put up. But, now that I don't do as much outside because just don't have the time to do it, we set ours up on Thanksgiving Eve.
So I think it's a little crazy to set up as early as he was saying, you know, at the end of October. However, for the houses that do these displays, this is why I'm complimenting Jeff. For the houses that do lights of 40 or 50 plus thousand, it's incredible. You make our communities brighter and better and share the holiday spirit with everyone. So, Jeff, compliments to you. And if you're doing those kinds of lights, compliments to you. That's all I got today.
Thanks. That's all we got on 97.5 WOKQ. Who loves you?
We do.